This is Agbogbloshie, a suburb of Accra, the capital of Ghana. But local residents have given it a nickname, Sodom and Gomorrah. It's the home of the biggest electronic waste dump and is a livelihood for many. First, it feeds them, then it kills them. This is one of the most polluted areas with toxins and toxic metals on the African continent. Emmanuel Akandirike has spent his entire childhood at the dump site. He's never been to school, so he can't go elsewhere. For him, this job is the only way to sustain himself.
One frame in my year, 14 years. Say, you will clone and papa demi bar. No cook, massy. A cook, massy, no jam or no member, and I'm by the edge. No catch him, say, me edge man, a yaka crow, beba, beba, and a quick pool.
Ghanaian laws forbid Emmanuel to work at all until he comes of age. But no one pays any attention.
And you see the small, small children, those who work here, you know, some of them don't have parents. Some of them father died, some of them their mothers died, and some of them their mothers are there, but they don't take care of them. You know, as a small boy, and some of them, they can't work here. After 12, they will go back to school. And some of them, they don't go to school at all. When they close school, they will come here. Some of them, early in the morning, they will come here, pick the iron, go and sell, get your money, go to school.
Nka company ye baby a omo we a obet na ye na mi de mi ye a mi ntimi nye sika ni mi se mi sisa adie na mi tna kwa koton kamet ma ye 2 and 4 and.
This money, which is equal to $3 to $5, will allow Emmanuel to have at least one meal a day. Electronic waste comes to Ghana from the USA, Australia, Western Europe and Asia to the tune of hundreds of tons per year. There's enough work here at the dump site for everyone. Waste collectors, as well as those whose job it is to provide anything the collectors might need. Samisa Abubakari Rubaba sells food and has only been here at the site for 2 weeks. She's from the north of Ghana, where there's no work at all.
So come among protector number that can I check. So can this some BC? That can I check? To qua, umbella and your person. Your pama will call out of parents in your hand for an book warm.
Samisa is 18, but she hasn't finished high school yet. She still has 2 more years to go.
No kunyebzika is na kam baba zama tashkur. Niyanyam kwa nini gisni?
ni ka chang school like no kama ni chang ss time mba ni chang nursing training ntuna nurse kan yi la ran lemba be kan lemma be kan len ya pa ma ku din ni ni ya shalamba
start the scraps. That was 1991. We were about 50 bed. Now we are about 4,000, 5,000. Our scrap is a good business because we do not this our scrap yard. Like our local companies, like they will not get goods. The local mills, we supply them the iron. No. We give them more.
No.
So our work is number one Ghana.
RB 131 SR 2087.
We look out for lead and cadmium, which could easily affect the people who spend time here, the kids who play around, the adults themselves. And WHO recommended level for lead in the soil is 400 parts per million. And you are getting a bit of 1,000, 2,000, dependent on where we sample.
Then we switch, then we go towards the road, where we started to, where we started from. Then we can start coming in.
We did some work in 2010 with Blacksmith and the Ghana Health Service. We took 80 people here to check their blood and urine to see the level of contamination. And it was quite high, very high. Quite high in terms of if you don't get any medication, you don't eat well, you don't move away from the surrounding, over a period of time, you fall sick. If you fall sick and you still don't get medication, definitely you will die.
You burn any plastic, you have toxin. And then you have combinations out of a list of poisons which are ranking under the highest poisons in the world. The combinations are much more dangerous and are much faster working in your organism, shortening your life much faster as if you are drinking everyday rat poison.
Victor Schaffer, a manager of a waste utilization company, came to Ghana from Germany. Working with waste here promised a high income, higher than in Western Europe.
I'm actually have joined the waste business to produce compost, because waste in Ghana contains more organic material as waste in Europe. I'm living here for 40 years, and I can say that the situation as such has not improved. And that is really dramatic. We have enough laws. It's not a question that we don't have enough laws. We have environmental laws, we have all the laws, but nobody's enforcing the laws, so everybody's doing what he wants. And that is a problem. And that causes problem for all these people here.
Exactly. Look out, just look at everything here. Exactly. Even where we are living, even where we used to work, to where we even eat,
yeah,
it's very bad for us.
Absolutely.
Look at human beings living here.
Yes, every day human they come closer.
Every day it's coming closer. Humans are living here.
Yes, yes.
We don't think about ourselves, but
no,
we think about the children.
But even yourself you have to think about.
You see?
Because you are also getting sick. And if you are getting sick, you cannot care for the children anymore. So the action is really serious. And therefore, we brought Sam here to have also from so outside,
least,
some international pressure.
You have to help us because it's not good.
The people which are owing the site are cashing in this waste. So they are making every day a lot of money, of course, without taxes.
Thank you.
Emmanuel's family has always lived in poverty. When his mother was alive, it wasn't that hard for the boy. She would always find a way to feed her son. But to do this, she had to work almost around the clock. Today has been a good day for Emmanuel. He's earned enough to buy food and can now have a rest in his temporary home. These two and three-storied shacks are right next to the dump site. People eat, sleep, and keep cattle here. No one pays attention to the smell coming from the dump site or the fact that they are surrounded by poison.
You can also argue, if you are cynic, that more people die on the road in Europe as people dying from this waste. In figures, maybe, but when you count how many people are sick and dying later, and how many of these kids have a very short life, and they are not registered while they are dying. Nobody says, oh, they were working in Nagpur Bloshi, therefore they made only 20, 22, 25 years, and then they are dead.
This is PML Children's Hospital. We, on a daily basis, we see children anywhere from 200 to 400 cases a day. We do see cases coming from the Abu Glushi area. So these are some of the general wards that we have here. Formerly, you know, there will be times we won't be getting so many patients. You know, but now it seems like we're getting cases throughout the year because we are seeing an increasing number of chest infections. So it's possible it could be attributable to some of these pollutants coming from these dump sites.
There are no official numbers as to how many people die of deadly poisoning in Abu Bloshi. No one registers the number of diseases caused by this ecological disaster. There are no statistics of it at all in Ghana.
Agbo Bloshi has two sides. On one side is the biggest fruit market in West Africa,
It's the biggest fruit magazine in Africa. And on the other side is the biggest contaminated site in the whole world, not only in West Africa. So, and this is just a street in between. So that means we are also accepting that when these kids are burning all these rubbers and plastics and all that, this smoke goes opposite the side to the food.
Markets, onions and all that. So effectively, the people who buy from here, and you realize there were cattle being reared at the site, they'll kill it, they'll cook, people will eat. So it's not only about the people here, but it spreads to other parts of Accra.
Ne kana ce ya nye kama niru pam na kama ni tonye shiba kama niru pam bam ni tonye shiba ka bo my friend ka so bien ko onu de business samu bien ba bien de business min nne nya sha ko nya like kama 17 to 15 ka bo my friend. So bien on tombe la cave au moins on te voit. So bien qu'on met la cave au moins quand il m'a fait des cœurs off. On te voit ma. Pour dire quoi là.
Bon,
on va ni be yan. Tom bash ko mbé mini nous. Nenye la arish el polo. Nibeyan tin ba shukun bay minen ni la arsha kun dabukun so shen kana tin tsira gin ni la arab zalf zan jan sen yo shkola kan chan in dabus ma in ku ta kan ka da shkun nan dan ma ka ce in peden su abuka bukwar mu so buka la arab dan ta ma na chan da zokati ba shkur kan ka fitu in ku in tsira gin da zokati ba shkur kan ka fitu balla arma.
Officially, no electronic waste comes to Ghana, only secondhand devices which are sold in shops.
Ha, with many idea be 100 million and idea be 150 million a day. It depends on man who won. And no let's say we organ for church. Church it means and I'm omo ye omo ye spinning na omo ye na obiet means. We no me home theater covers and now we no me speakers are join them ema for amplifiers. We use your plants with my plant for lights off with my use for see computer monitors. Yeah, all is second hand goods. Oh, do you have a repair? Do you have a neighbor in your past? No, in general, say, oh, your past, they are. Let's say, no, they condemn. No, let's say, no, any, let's say, no, you have one or almost a bit fat, almost a bit of torn almost.
When
did
you say, yeah, and
it's our
business?
Yeah, oh, yeah, and also, yes, yeah, you did be 20 years, a chef feed, maybe, yeah. Ha me manage sa adwuma no ho and anya me nko ana manage ho everybody obi a oyey work obi a no manage ho.
Victor Schaffer believes the trade of second-hand electronics in Ghana is really no more than a cover for e-waste traffic, and it's highly profitable, turning over around $250 million per year.
This is somehow a mafia. The ones which are collecting these used computers over there, so what you do is you have a 40-foot container. In the back of the 40-foot container, you pack all the computers which are crap, monitors, whatever you want. And in the front, you pack the ones which are still functioning.
This is the main trick that suppliers of e-waste use. Utilizing broken-down devices in developed countries is too costly. So they are sent to Ghana, to the dump site.
Everybody knows about the value of these containers. Yeah? So when you have a 40-footer, you can half calculate with a little bit what you can sell and the scrap which is inside there, it's a 40,000 euros affair. To maximize his profit, he selects these poor boys, which are coming from the north and from all the sides, to Accra to find a little bit shop money. Direct, you can never go to the expert and say, look, my friend, you were the guilty one. You have killed 5 kids in Africa. Yeah? This you cannot prove. And of course, he will not take up the blame. He will say, I have sold used materials to somebody who came to my yard and bought it. I don't know what he's doing with it.
Now, what's the side of the map? 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 Your brother is on a sofa, on a number. No, a friend, no, so me was Juma, no, a friend, no, a catcher, and say, me bar, uncontained, and say, Yaka crown, or so ever, near queer crew. Now, me G phone, and my friend is on the phone.
And some of them are here, so everybody works here. And some people too are here, and some people too are here. So you see how the work it is. Everybody is doing his hard work. So that's the business.
The dump site at Agbogbloshie is divided into sectors, each of which has its own supervisor. But the last word always belongs to Abdullahi Abdul Rahmani.
I'm in charge of everybody here. If anybody have a problem, they can bring it here. So I will judge it. If you don't have right, I will tell you your matter, you don't have right. So let's do it like this. Let's sort. Or if somebody collects somebody's money or somebody offends somebody, they will come here. I will talk to them so that everything will make cool. Assuming that even yesterday, I was at police station. They beat some of our boy, Igbo boy, cut in ear. They arrest the boys. Even yesterday, I even went there to solve the problem for them so that this will calm down, so that the fight will stop. And sometimes when they arrest them at police station or other places, I'm the one who is going there.
Mi se e kanta fona anopana mi koya na boy bi na mi furu tron na mi kona ho o peso yi mi sika na mi huye na mi kachre boys bi na mo jimi sika ma na mo bonu mi jana koya. Bueno, mi se me bae no na club yo omotobo na mi se me chia mamu ne anopa ebet masona anopa ne akoko ye train na ebe ya nyunde se ne ba we bobo kakra ne akoko jani. Ejuma bia ni o mpe bono na ngeti.
Let the do. Come in on Amaria. Yarris, Yan through Legitima, cut through a family legitima. The Enchoco Bazaar, Yurma can come only with Yurma, Coma, Yurma. So young Villa de Hasson to Minu. The Enchican to Afan.
To feed themselves, to survive in Accra, they have to get somehow in this system. The ones which are dealing with the e-waste, they know all that, and they calculate all that. And if they give them, let's say, 5 or 8 Ghana cedis a day, so that they can more or less survive, the boys have no choice. They cannot say, I want more money. They say, you want more money? Okay, kick you out.